On Sundays,
my family used to congregate in the backyard on the red wooden deck. We lounged in the folding chairs and let the sun strike, watched as it spread to the contours of our bodies. Noticed home felt warm today. Some days, the deck was for barbecues, cookouts, and water fights. Food so good, it didn't even need sauce.
No, it didn't.
We never had to mask an ugly truth. Here, family became a familiar word I highlighted for safekeeping.
On Fridays, my sisters and I wake up early, lie in the hallway, waiting to get into the little bathroom the five of us shared. We'll do shine wrists and ankles dripping down the stairs as we shuffle our way to Jama'ah. All of us laughing and arguing in our little line as our feet dance from the masjid to Girl Scouts to back home again for snow ice cream and movie nights and sleepovers in the bright blue basement.
Time turns home into a funny thing. It warps itself like wood in the floorboards.
Buckles like carpet after 10 little feet traverse the distance of adulthood on it.
Home grows small as I grow big.
It shrinks and shrinks until I squeeze out the sides, burst through the windows, and ooze out from under the front door. My mom doesn't even seem to have noticed that my head has exploded out of the chimney and my eyes have taken up the sky after moving out or growing up or something like that.
Now,
some days I wonder why I am not home.
Childhood sets with its summers.
Autumn comes and the leaves shed and so does that sweet suburban life.
Hatchlings must always leave the nest, and the neighborhood children are no exception. So we watch as our world falls apart and we lose our ownership. 2 years away and suddenly the word home loses its weight, doesn't quite balance on the tongue like it used to.
I mold and shape myself in different ways when I'm away. Stretch my toes out, inhale, until my insides turn to the outside and the outside is newness. But the house is exactly the same. The sofa, the tables, the fish tank have not moved or breathed or even closed their eyes for one moment.
I speak to neighbors and friends, and my tongue has picked up a new dialect.
They are the same, but I am not.
It doesn't sound quite right when its two words converge and I become a walking contradiction.
We sit across the table from each other, trying to figure out if there's enough of the way that we knew each other to not be strangers. Suddenly,
this place isn't mine anymore.
I don't unpack my suitcases all summer. They stay stacked with things I didn't need or never found the courage to move into my drawers. My sisters frown when I interject into an argument.
You don't live here anymore,
they say. My mom calls me to wash the dishes, and somehow they don't feel like mine anymore, but hers. I'm a guest,
a visitor. I still visit home during breaks.
The weekend or the summers. My body exhales whenever I reach the driveway.
Mama's face lights up when she sees me, yet it has a hint of sadness.
It's always exhausting having to hold it all in, swollen with the pain, never being able to release.
She knows this can't last, and sure enough, it doesn't, but
we both want it to feel like home again.
We step out onto that wooden deck, notice that it's traded its color for dust and brown. It has weathered too many storms.
And we have too.
It makes sense it's lost its familiarity.
And we have too.
We scrub the dirt from the deck's hard exterior, relive those memories again and again and again until we make more of our own. And there's that red. It's just like we left it.
On a Friday this past summer, I moved the furniture in my bedroom for the first time in 10 years. I moved my bed to the other wall and the desk and the dresser. I bought new sheets and a new comforter, told my mom I was new now.
Home needed to be new now. I needed to fit through the door and not fall over the ledge. I needed to be able to rest here and not be left anxious, wondering why nowhere felt quite like home.